Hello, folks. This is Ron Howard, Extreme Sequences, bringing you extreme short tips. I tried the 2-minute tips and then went to 8-minute tips, and now we're just going to call these short tips. If they take 2 minutes, great. They take 6, 8, 10, 12. If it takes an hour, well, okay, you're never ever going to want to hear me again, so I promise never to do that. But in keeping up with the tradition of sharing some of these tutorials and tips, I thought of one that I thought was pretty interesting, and because people ask about this sequence quite a bit and its syncopation, the intricate amount of detail that went into it was a lot. There was a lot of time spent on this sequence called Turn Down for What. And what helped me get through some of this to save some time were the vamp plugins. Let's face it. Trying to eyeball this and placing these lines on here using the letter T when you click in this area up here, that's great for tapping along, but sometimes a song is so intricate and the syncopation is so complex that you need a little more help. Otherwise, I could be here for months trying to get through this. If you're not familiar with how to use the timings, you'll see here I have note onsets and I have beats. These are two of the most used ones that I employ in my sequencing. But if we wanted to put others, we could simply click on sequence settings at the top under the settings. And then from here we have some choices. If we click this third tab at the top called timings, it will allow us to see what we may already have for our timing grids. If we click new, we have choices, and these are the vamp plugins. Now, if you do not see this drop down list, that means during your installation it did not automatically install the vamp plugins, which it should do. If you go to xLights.org, you can always find vamp plugins for 32-bit and 64-bit applications. So that being said, we're right back here. We have everything from 25 milliseconds, 50 milliseconds, 100 milliseconds, metronome, just leave it empty. Perhaps you want to put some lyrics in there. Sometimes I'll add lyrics through the empty track because I want to know where I'm going to put some emphasis. I'm not using it for singing faces per se, but I'm using it for a feeling or emotion on the whole house or the mega tree or the matrix. One of my favorites here is the bar and beat tracker beats. I use that a lot. And of course, if we scroll down here to note onsets, you can use that. There's a lot of different ones in here. I've played with a lot of these. The polyphonic transcription is pretty cool if you want to use the piano. What this will do is it will take a listen to the music and try to transcribe it polyphonically, notating where notes are, and then you can see that playback on the piano. I haven't had a great need for that in my show. It's cool, some nice eye candy, but it's just not my cup of tea. And the rest of these you can just experiment with. And it's a simple, and let's just put a 50 millisecond on here. We'll click OK, and then it fills it out. There's our 50 milliseconds, and we click Done. You can see that the 50 milliseconds is pretty detailed in here. If I deselect that, we can look at note onsets. And then I'll deselect that and click on beats. So where did I use beats? Well, beats was used in a section like this here, and I'm gonna play this. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, so I can count, that's awesome. So this is in 4-4 time. That's pretty simple. That's easy to program a beat there, but what I want you to watch here, I'm going to play this section again. Watch what the Living Light Show Flakes are doing. Do you see how it's bouncing with the music? Boom, boom, boom. That was pretty easy to achieve. If we look at this VU meter effect that I used here, I told it to use timing event color, so it was going to go from red to this bluish color here. And I told it to use note onsets. So it's listening for the note onsets. It's listening for what's happening if, and I'll change it so you can see. In the note onsets, see if you can follow the beat from right here. And we'll play just through this section here. Turn down for what? pretty cool. It did a lot of the work for us, which is fantastic. Anything we can do to be efficient in sequencing is very welcomed. Let's go over to another section here. This was a lot of fun to do. If we look at, this is the house verts all, and I wanted to get some movement here. Let's listen to a little bit of this. Boom, 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 boom. And it was the note onsets that really helped with that. If I only had beats in here, you can see that it's on top and going over the line with the beats. And so that wouldn't work. And I'd have to eyeball this and I'd have to drag lines over, whereas the note onsets really help me dial this in. And I can zoom in just a little bit further so we can really take a look at this. Even with these guys here, if I were using beats only, that's not gonna cut it. The music isn't always on a time track. It's not always metronomically perfect. We sometimes like to pretend it is, but it's not, and sometimes things will ebb and flow. But when you have electronic music like this, a lot of times it's pretty doggone close, enough for you to bank on using these tools, the Vamp plugins. So I really like them. They save me a lot of time. If you're not already programming with Vamp plugins, you're not using the timings up here, you really should. The timing tracks are invaluable to help you out with your sequencing. Now, again, I could go up here and click add timing track, and we'll call this by feel, which I'll usually do. And if I'm gonna do this by feel, let's just do this little section here. And I'm gonna just let it play, and I'm gonna hit the letter T where I think it's important. Okay, so interesting. Was I going with the beat? Not necessarily. I was playing beats within it and around it. So for me, if I were going to add things here, I would put things that are on the backside of the beats to have fun. So yes, I know not everybody is a drummer, but if you can have fun with this, you can do some pretty fun things with by feel just to throw it off and give it more of a reflective nature with the rhythms. Again, no rules, no wrongs here. So I hope that addresses any questions you may have about Vamp plugins, the timings, the milliseconds, the different ways you can put information in here. And of course, you know, when you drag, you can change these anytime you like when you're on them. That's by feel. I can go to my 50 milliseconds, and yes, I could even change these if I wanted. Or I could delete it, and I'll delete the timing track. No, I don't want that. You can also right-click and export the timing track. So you can export this and name it with the name of the song, should you want to share that or bring it back in later for something else. So anyway, that's just a few things you could do. It's really a lot of fun to get in here and play with timing. You don't have to be a drummer. You just have to kind of goof with it a little bit. If you have any questions, drop me a line. Let me know. Let me know if this stuff is helpful. I want to make sure I'm not wasting air and that you guys are getting something out of these short tips. All right, take care, guys.